Good morning, Bridgeport High School. Today is May 12, 2017, and this year WBHS News, and I'm Miranda Bowers. The Spring Band Concert will be held this evening, beginning at 6, in the cafeteria. The band will be playing popular tunes such as Brington Beach, Irish Jig, Evening in the Country, Mission Impossible, and Trails of Glory. Come and listen to our concert band playing these memorable tunes.
The U.S. Postal Service thanks to students of Bridgeport School District for their recent donations to their annual food drive. Over 600 pounds of food was brought in to help our friends and neighbors.
Students can earn service hours for helping the middle school students in their Making Space endeavor. If you are interested, please see Mrs. Haverty.
The Olympics will be taking place today. Good luck to all teams.
The baccalaureate service for the class of 2017 will be held on Thursday, May 25th, beginning at 6 in the cafeteria. The service is sponsored by the Bridgeport Friendship Council.
The class of 2017 has selected our classmates for the following senior superlatives. Most likely to succeed, Josie Bugon, Trevin Clark. Most school spirit, Samantha Ivan and Dylan Okoski. Most artistic, Daniel Dawson and Caleb Nelson. Most athletic, Deja Massey and Dane Cash. Class clown, Emilio Saldana and Tierra White. Best dressed, Misha Berry and Emilio Saldana.
Best personality, McKenna Beal and Jace Johnston. Most inseparable friends, Candace Kinzerski and Tierra White. Best bromance, Emilio Saldana and Matt Herring. Cutest couple, Jasmine Rogers and Eli Williams. Most gullible, Samantha Ivan and Alex Kim. Best smile, Miranda Bowers and Thomas Coyd.
Teacher's pet, Josie Bugon and Trevin Clark. Best to bring home to your parents, Hannah Petrosky and Jace Johnston. Cutest couple that never was, Josie Bugon and Trevin Clark. Most likely to win the lottery ticket and lose the ticket, Caitlin Clement and Dane Cash. Biggest ego, Miranda Bowers and Matt Herring. Most likely to win an argument, Deja Massey and Guy Pagano.
Most likely to get handed the ox, Hannah Petrosky and Caleb Nelson. Most likely to be late to graduation, Misha Berry and Dane Cash. Worst case of senioritis, Jamie Zifsel and Dane Cash. Best hair / most likely to get bald, Jasmine Rogers and Jace Johnston. Best Snapchat story, Tierra White and Matt Herring. And most likely to crash on the couch, Deja Massey and Dane Cash. We will see how many of these awards are true to their future class reunions.
Semester exams begin for seniors on Monday and for underclassmen on Tuesday. Check the schedule in teachers' classrooms.
And I'm Thomas Coyne. I had the chance to interview our superintendent, Mr. Zach Shuttler, for the last time of the school year. So, looking back on the year, what do you see as some of the highlights?
First, Mr. Coyne, thanks for having me. This is our last superintendent's address, and good luck to you after graduation.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Going back to the highlights, rewinding to the beginning of the year, introducing and unveiling our mission and vision statement to the folks at Bulldog Pride Night was a big moment. And the best part about that moment was working with the principals to have our students stand in front of the crowd and talk about what tradition, community, the future, and responsibility meant to them. They got to showcase their public speaking skills, their writing skills, and their leadership skills in that moment. So to me, that really set the tone for the start of a great school year. Moving forward, when we created the commercial for supporting public schools, that was a big highlight. And to me, it was a highlight. It gave me the opportunity to work with Mr. Davenport's class, Ms. Mendelson's class, and our students to create something that was unique and really of professional quality. When you walk through our main lobby, you still see that playing today, all of us supporting public schools and creating a very, very cool commercial that to me, I think that could be on television. So seeing the awesome work that our students do, that was very neat. Going to the middle school and the high school, the production of Annie, excellent, very well done. We are a small school, 200 and some high school students, so you don't have a large pool of actors and actresses to select from. But even with that deficit, I thought our students really, really performed very well. Great production of Annie. Elementary school, going and reading to them, always a highlight. Seeing the teacher's enthusiasm and the creative projects they create is fantastic. Our Title I reading night was very cool. Having students as young as kindergarten stand up and read books that they wrote to parents in the audience, again, gives them an opportunity to showcase their leadership skills. So that was some very cool things. Anything that our students are doing where they're displaying their talents, whether it be on the athletic field or in the classroom, is a joy to watch and definitely a highlight. Very quickly, behind the scenes, working with our teachers, our DLT team, to actually create together meaningful professional development. That has been something that's been a highlight. Our partner with West Liberty University, we had a class after school in the spring and fall semesters where teachers earn credits by reading books and sharing what they do in the classroom. So to me, those have all been excellent highlights. Our teachers taking on increased leadership roles and seeing themselves not just as an educator, but as a learner, and coming together as colleagues and sharing information. I know that's been very meaningful to me, and I hope so for them, and I think it's made us all better leaders. So those have all been some major highlights.
So after getting out of the 2016-17 school year, we have some time to relax this summer and all that, but what are some big changes that we can expect for the 17-18 school year?
Well, 17-18 school year, we have some changes, and to me, when you look at a school, we have the new concession stand. Yes, we've made some upgrades to our facilities, but the school is all about people and relationships. And we're going to be missing some of our really dedicated staff members next year who are retiring, and of course our seniors who are going on to the next step of their journey. So, I'll just share with you those staff members who are deciding to retire. And first, we'll talk about Mr. Zitzelberger. He has made the decision to retire after 14 years, and he has really dedicated himself to the district. Anybody who takes time to speak with him knows how much he cares not only about the students, but of the reputation of Bridgeport School. It doesn't take long to realize that he sets high expectations for the students, and he holds them accountable. And that's what I think his legacy at Bridgeport will be. Mrs. Mendelson, she's also retiring. She works through the Career Center with our students, and she does so many things outside of the classroom. She puts together the Queen of Queens pageant. She puts together the Necro Golf Scramble that raises money for the school. She does so many things, just rattling them off, the close-up trip to Washington, D.C., so she will definitely be missed. And then finally, Mrs. Moore, she's our current EMIS coordinator. And a great personal story I can say about Mrs. Moore is when I graduated college, I was a substitute teacher here at Bridgeport. So we're talking $50 a day, walking into classrooms to where the students don't know me. I know sometimes you guys like to give subs a hard time.
Yeah.
So that was me all those years back. And I can honestly say every time I walked into that office to sign in, she treated me back then like I was the superintendent then. And that's the way that I see her treat everybody that walks in the door. She greets them with a huge smile, and she treats everybody like they are important. And that's the way that everybody should feel when they step into our school. So all of them will be missed. So that's going to be the big change headed into next year. Transitioning, we're going to have Mr. Thomas Daly. He's going to take over as our new head principal. So we're looking forward to getting him into the building, meeting the students, meeting the teachers. And I think going forward, some of the biggest changes are that we are going to really work hard to try to find creative leadership roles for students so that way they can take and use their talents to the fullest and take our culture to the next level here as a district.
So lastly, as we start to conclude our last interview together here at Bridgeport, what are some of your plans for the summer?
Plans for the summer. Typically we take a vacation, but we were fortunate early spring, we took a vacation to Disney World. So we already have our vacation in, and that was awesome. Going forward, I plan on, you know, obviously doing some work here at the school, getting things in place as far as our staff, but more importantly, spending quality time with the family, watching my son's baseball games, my daughter's softball games, and just relaxing and just the same thing I think in any field that you do, you need to take a little step back, reassess your priorities, and, you know, ask yourself why you're doing it and rediscover that purpose and come back next year with the same type of motivation to be a positive influence on people and establish good relationships and keep building our school's culture so that all of us take pride in what we are doing here.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Coyne. What are you going to do after graduation?
Well, I'm going to the Columbus Division of Fire, trying to get a job out in Columbus for the city as
Great.
A firefighter. And soon I'm starting my EMT up at Eastern Gateway. So,
your purpose, your why is you're going to be out there helping people.
I'd like to.
Great. We wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Coyne.
And I'm Hannah Petrosky with your sports. Any girl interested in playing volleyball in the fall is asked to sign up in the office. The Spring Sports Bank will be held on Sunday, May 21st, beginning at 3 p.m. Baseball, softball, and track team members are urged to turn in their reservations to their coach ASAP. Reservation deadline is Tuesday, May 16th. The district track meet begins on Tuesday, May 16th and continues on Friday, May 19th.
And I'm Thomas Coyne with your positive news. A McDonald's employee with Down syndrome celebrated his retirement on Monday after 33 years of dedicated service. Daniel Lindbrick of Howe, Michigan, began working at McDonald's in April of 1984 as the lobby manager. With over three decades of service under his belt, Daniel became known for his work ethic and contagious smile. A surprise party celebrating Daniel's retirement was held at the Bradenton McDonald's Monday, filling the lobby with his friends, family, and community members, who have all been impacted by Daniel's lovable personality. The event included taking gifts and memory books for guests to sign. David Glenn, made general manager at the Bradenton McDonald's, has worked with Daniel for 13 years. Above all else, he said, Daniel makes everybody feel special. Nicki Minaj is paying off student loans for her Twitter followers. Nicki spent her past weekend teaching her fans that it pays to get good grades. Nicki offered more than $20,000 in student loans for dozens of her fans on one condition. They must have straight A's or an impressive GPA. Minaj was initially answering questions about a lip-sync contest surrounding her Regret It In Your Tears music video, but she shifted gears when one Twitter follower asked if she would pay for her college tuition. Minaj agreed and opened up the opportunity to others. The response was immediate, with fans sending screenshots of report cards, progress reports, and stories of financial hardship and educational goals. Nicki replied to 30 fans, telling them to send info for her to pay for their tuition, school loans, and needed equipment.
Lunch for today will be a summer picnic in conjunction with the Olympics. Your weather this weekend will be a high of 57 and a low of 47 with a chance of light rain on Friday. Saturday, it will be a high of 59 with a low of 49 and be partly cloudy. Sunday, there is a high of 60 and a low of 45 and it will be partly cloudy as well. Have a great weekend, Bridgeport.
Leave my door open just a crack.
Please take me away from here.
'Cause I feel like such an insomniac. Eyes as they said.